Oh, I do apologize. Am I disturbing you?
No, please. Do come in, Mrs.
My name is Miss Alice de Bouvier. I'm Mr. Holmes' new neighbor.
Oh, I didn't have the pleasure to... I am Dr. John Watson. Could we provide you with any assistance?
Oh, she is not the concern, Watson.
I'm... Then, what is this about?
That child standing sniffling behind her. Get rid of him, Watson.
But he is shivering with cold. And he is upset. What happened to him?
Little Tom knocked at the wrong door.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Oh, boy, come in. Warm yourself by the fire. Can I offer you a cup of tea, Miss de Bouvier?
Well, I...
It is not as though we are disturbing you know who. Are we?
I suppose not.
Since you are our new neighbor, it is perhaps better that you know what he's like.
You're starting to worry me.
Well, Mr. Holmes is relapsing. This illness that he has seizes him when he finds himself with nothing to do. He becomes completely asocial. And alas, this is a very difficult, medically incurable case. Now this must stay between us.
Of course, I understand. How very sad.
But there is a cure, if only a temporary one. A thrilling inquiry. Most certainly. If he refuses this one, then his condition will worsen.
Oh, I am still here, you know. I didn't fall out of the window. Very well, then.
Thank you, miss.
Now tell me, boy, what brings you here?
It's my father, sir. He's missing. I don't know what to do.
What's his name?
George Hurst, sir.
Missing, eh? And what do the police say?
The police? They don't believe me. They say he's just abandoned me. But that's a lie.
Obviously. Your clothes are well mended and you can read. Your parents may be poor, but you are loved.
Yeah, well, it's just the two of us now. My mother died when I was a little one.
And that's just one more reason for not leaving you. Your father doesn't seem the irresponsible type. He's very good to you.
Well, that's right. but he has no fixed work, so he often takes odd jobs for the day, because that's all he can find. Only this time, he didn't come home.
And when was the last time you saw him?
3 weeks ago. He left for a new job, but this time, he was acting a bit strange and angry.
Strange? In what way?
He said to me, "Son, I'm out on a special job. Don't you dare move from here." I think something went wrong.
3 weeks? That's a long time.
Well, every day I thought he would show up. And anyway, I can look after myself.
What were you thinking? You and your father are both at risk. You should have come to me much earlier.
I was afraid. I ain't got no family, and I've got no other place to go. If our landlord finds out that Father left me, he'll throw me out on the street.
Tom, you've been very resourceful. We shall be discreet.
If only my mother was still here.
Very well. Your address, please, Tom.
12 Dorset Street, the first floor, door E. It's in Whitechapel, sir. But I ain't got no money to pay.
Who asked for money, Tom? Your case seems to be the very medicine I need. I'll meet you there shortly.
Oh, thank you, sir.
These streets are too narrow for the cab. I'll have to walk. North Street.
Sorry, I'm working. I can't open the door.
North Street. There's nobody at home. I don't feel thirsty right now.
Strangers.
Whitechapel High Street. Excuse me, how can I get to Dorset Street? Is it far?
You're heading the wrong way. You need to go back and then go through the arch.
This is our home, Mr. Holmes.
The old Tabard pub, North Street. Glue.
Please, sir, find my father.
So that's why you came to see me. A collection of worn-out and second-hand books. George Hurst was
Father bought all those books for me. He didn't tell me.
Food's running low. It's already 3 weeks since George Hurst did... Well, I can see the preparations for peasant soup, a clever concoction for somebody with apparently no culinary skills. Hurst covered his bills ahead of time, thus providing Tom with security and sustenance.
My mother, sir. She died when I was very young. My father told me what she was like. But that's all I have.
I'm sorry, Tom. George Hurst's work was varied. He was evidently a hard-working and valuable hand.
The roof leaks all the time. Father used to fix it. I hope you'll find my father soon.
Whitechapel never changes. Dirt and beggars everywhere.
I don't want to go, but there's bugger everywhere.
I couldn't pay the rent last week.
Pumpkin! Cabbage! Cheap!
Rich folk feed meat to their dogs. I can't even remember what meat tastes like.
Living costs are too much these days. My son has to work down the sewers. He's only 7.
My analysis table. It's useful for my work. Thank you. Old clothes, soiled and worn. It's too dark. I can't see anything. A leather satchel, what's in it? Just some old things. The old Tabard pub? Did you hear anything about it from your father, Tom?
My father's a regular, but he's not a drinker, sir. It's close by on North Street.
Good day, Mr. Holmes.
Well, if it isn't young Wiggins. And I see you found yourself a job.
If you can call it that. I hate it. But if you've got any proper work for me...
I just might be in need of your assistance later. Wait here.
Chapel never changes. Dirt and beggars everywhere.
I couldn't pay the rent last week.
Pumpkin! Cabbage! Cheap!
Rich folk feed meat to their dogs.
Living costs are too much these days. My son has to work down the sewers. He's only 7.
I need to Earwig to find out who is offering this special job. There's no one to eavesdrop on from here.
The child labour law sent your kids to school instead of the coal mine.
Offering the special jobs. He never drinks alcohol. Equality for the working class.
I'm glad I'm my own boss. I can complain only to myself. Or to Watson.
The man who's offering that special job has a proper set of mutton chop whiskers.
So, the man I'm looking for has whiskers and never drinks alcohol.
Bosses beware. When we're screwed, we multiply.
It's not him.
Dump the bosses off your backs.
This must be the man that I'm looking for. Interesting. A missing person. I should find out more.
See that gentleman? I need you to follow him and report back to me.
All right, Mr. Holmes.
Don't lose him.
Chapel never changes. Dirt and beggars everywhere.
Get away from me, boy!
They won't let me pass. I'll need to find another way.
Rich folk feed meat to their dogs. I can't even remember what...
Living costs are too much these days. My son has to work down the sewers. He's only 7.
What are you waiting for?
Ah, boys from the Bruisers gang. Better keep out of their way.
Stupid kid. Take a brush and get in there.
Who do we have here? Get him!
Stop crying and get to work.
Ah, boys from the Bruisers gang. Better keep out of their way.
stupid kid.
I'll be able to continue the chase if I climb up the chimney, but it's dangerous.
Stop crying and get to work.
Please, you don't have to beat him. I'll do it. I'll clean the chimney.
Go on then.
Still here, that's a relief.
What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? Or I in the morning?
No place to hide here. We'd better go through the yard.
Get away from me, boy!
Thank you. shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? Or lie in the morning?
Oi! What are you doing in my garden?
Hey, Jim. Can you lend me your kit? I'm on a secret mission for Mr. Holmes.
Mm-hmm.
Did you fall asleep?
This could be useful with a small brush. This could...
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm still learning. He's talking with a cabbie. I need to get closer. Damn! I need to find another.
Alas, the weather's good. Last week was freezing.
I'm praying it doesn't get cold again. I've no money for coal.
Can't lose him now. I've lost him. I can't lose him now. interesting. What's going on in the yard? I need to get into the yard. Too dangerous to enter. I can't see what's inside. Do only two people live here? I wish one was me. Bags of food. I like this house. It's too dangerous to enter. Locked. I can't see what's inside. I can't see what's inside. A coat of arms. It might help Mr. Holmes. I'll make a drawing of it. Time to report to Mr. Holmes. Let's get outside before I get caught.
Wigan's tale was quite unusual. What do you make of what he found, Holmes?
Wigan's did a good job. My analysis table. useful for my work. That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. Not the one I need. That's 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 not the one I need. Not the one I need. Here it is. So this man could be Lord Marsh. Huh. A lord who hangs around in a public house. Let's pay a visit to Lord Marsh. We'll pretend that we're interested in his charitable activities.
Mr. Holmes, you have a visitor.
Oh, just ask him to wait.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. This young lady refuses to wait for anything.
What?
Father!
Caitlin!
Miss Caitlin's boarding school was flooded. Everyone was sent home.
As if it could smell any mustier.
My word, how is it possible that you have grown up so fast?
You'll be staying. Wherever will we put you?
Holmes, I'll give her my room, of course.
What do you have to say, Kate?
You're on a new case. A respectable lady who's being blackmailed? Or is it a love story between a prince and a suffragist?
However did you guess?
You will tell me, won't you, Father?
We'll see, if you behave.
All right, then. Have fun. I'll go and unpack. Will you help me, Mrs. Hudson?
Holmes, about Caitlin.
Yes?
She has grown up, hasn't she? Don't you think it's time to tell her?
To tell her what, Watson?
Well, about her father.
Never. Absolutely never. Do you hear me?
Holmes, you were responsible for the death of her father. You owe her the truth. She is old enough now.
I would lose her. Can't you see that? She must never know, Watson. Is that clear?
Holmes.
It won't and can't happen.
Come in, please. Good day, gentlemen. Welcome to my home. How may I help you?
Good day to you, Lord Marsh. My name is Sherlocke Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson. I hope we're not disturbing you. You are with your physician?
Yes, this is Dr. Reuben Fisher. But no, please, I'm intrigued by your visit, Mr. Holmes.
I'm glad to hear it. The last thing I'd wish is to upset the patient. Lord Marsh, can I just say that I admire all of your efforts in assisting the poor of London?
Yes. It is a war that we must fight on our streets and now, too, from my home. You must surely have noticed those bags full of items, clothing and books for the unfortunate.
That is inspirational. At my own humble level, I too try my best to support those in need. I thought perhaps that I could be of some assistance.
I don't see why not. I already have the valuable assistance of Dr. Fisher, who happens to be my personal physician.
Forgive me, Lord Marsh. You're looking very pale. Might I offer Dr. Watson's assistance?
That is kind of you, but I feel confident that I can provide Lord Marsh with the care that he requires.
How long have you been like this, my lord?
I'm fine, Dr. Watson. Don't fuss. It's only influenza. I'll be better in a few days.
In that case, why are you taking such powerful painkillers?
Excuse me, what do you mean?
Mr. Holmes is referring to the pills on your table.
I'm sorry, but that's a medical confidentiality.
It's curious. Your face seems familiar to me, Doctor. Oddly, I'm associating it with Whitechapel.
Well done. You are right. I do occasionally frequent a few hostelries over there, would you believe it? Not that I am a drinker. But there, dressed as a working man, I can approach the other fellows to see if they might be interested in a special job.
A special job? May I ask what you're referring to?
Certainly. Since Lord Marsh began his special education program in 1889, he foresaw that such people would need an occupation of some kind. And so, with or without education, we propose these opportunities to work with Lord Marsh. It offers the less fortunate a chance to help make London a better place.
That's remarkable.
Yes, indeed. In order to truly see, one requires vision, yes? But also insight. And Lord Marsh has believed this since he was a child.
Oh, Dr. Fisher makes it all sound so romantic. Let's close this topic.
Lord Marsh even helps hospitals. A provision dealing with the paupers of Whitechapel. Lord Marsh hunting with his friends.
Ah, my dear comrades, Lord Collins and Lord Harrington. If it wasn't for this godforsaken English malady, I'd be with those rapscallions right now.
All in due time, my lord.
Last year, 3 orphans were put through medical college. Thanks to Lord Marsh and the special education program, a great many poor people will have a second chance in life. I've never heard of this man. I've never heard of this man. John Strobridge. I've seen this name before. It was on a missing persons poster.
I can't quite work it out. Do you have any ideas to the number of people who might owe you their lives?
Oh, don't embarrass me, Mr. Holmes. But indeed, these people have become like a family to me.
That would be a fairly large family, I imagine.
Yes, the list would be longer than any of your short stories. As for how large, well, Fisher is the one who keeps record.
Might we take a glance at the list?
I regret that is impossible. It is confidential. I stand firm upon that point, Mr. Holmes.
I quite understand. We'll most certainly send a donation towards your educational program.
I shall take my leave then. I thank you both, and I wish you all the very best, gentlemen. Likewise, Mr. Holmes.
Humanitarian aid for an orphanage. Aid for the paupers of Lambeth Workhouse. It's extremely honourable to devote one's whole life. Bags full of food. Locked. It's shut tight. Locked.
Lord Marsh believes that he can help all these poor people.
Despite my title, yes. I have to share my home with these bags full of food for the poor.
I'm intrigued by the special education program.
Is there something else that interests you?
Lord Marsh believes that he can help all these poor people.
I'm intrigued by the special education program.
It's closed.
It's shut tight.
It's closed.
It's shut tight.
It appears that Lord Marsh spent a great deal of his money on aiding the poor. I've never seen so many provisions for the poor, and certainly not in a lord's house.
I'm gratified by your interest in my charity. You're the first who has offered to help.
I'm intrigued by the special education program.
It's closed. It's closed.
Holmes, we need to help poor Tom.
A map of London and its surroundings. I won't disturb Lord Marsh without a reason. I won't disturb Lord Marsh.
Mr. Holmes, do you have any news about my father?
Tom, not so fast. I wanted to ask you if you remember your father mentioning anything about a special education program.
An education program? No, he only talked about a special job.
What's this box, Tom?
Oh, yeah, I just found it, Mr. Holmes. It was ever so well hidden. I've no idea why.
Well done, my boy. It could prove very helpful. A ramrod to clean a rifle. Wolfjack. Looks like a military badge. This oil can also be used on weapons. Tom, does your father own a rifle?
A rifle? No. If he had, he would have shown it me.
I'm sure that he wouldn't have shown it you. I need to find this rifle. This scrap of cloth was used to oil a firearm. Tom, does your father have any other property?
No. Well, at least I don't think so.
I have to take Toby. He'll take a sniff of the oil, and we'll find that rifle.
Holmes, we need to help poor Tom.
Come on, Toby. It's time for you to earn your keep. Watson?
I prefer to visit Lord Marsh. I'm worried about the condition of his health.
Search, Toby. Search.
No.
It's only a garden shed. Let's go on. Just some old things. It's not here. Ordinary storage. Old things. Tom's photograph. Let's try to get inside. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lock. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lock. News clippings on Lords and the education program. Why are they here? Let's compare this list with the evidence that we found earlier. This is the list of selected participants for October's special education program. According to this poster, John Strobridge is missing. Let's compare them with people from Hearst documents. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. I don't think so. I should pay more attention to details. This man appears in both documents. All the people in Marsh's document are marked and dated in George Hurst's files. This case must have been full of cartridges.
A map of Epping Forest. Rubbish. Was something on the stand. There was a rifle here. George Hurst took it with him.
Holmes, what are you doing here? What are you planning?
A mission of my own. You must play the role of the conscientious doctor while I sneak inside Marsh's house. That's the only way of helping little Tom. This is not the best way to sneak in. The window is firmly shut. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lock. There's no space for this lockpick. 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 There's no space. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no space for this lockpick. There's no There's no space for this lockpick. 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 There's no space for this lockpick.
How can I help you?
I came to visit Lord Marsh.
What for?
I would very much like to see Lord Marsh, if you please.
Oh, you're so clumsy. Can you please not...
I have to visit Lord Marsh and offer him my services.
Fisher, please allow Dr. Watson to enter.
Good job, Watson. Lord Marsh is a... Lord Marsh is a keen hunter. Lord Marsh... I have to finish my search of the office. I can hide here. Let's see how hard to crack this safe is.
Doctor, it appears that you were impatient to pay me another visit.
Indeed. Will you allow me to examine you? A second opinion, so that the great Lord Marsh does not become the late Lord Marsh.
Well, since you put it that way, very well.
Shall I retire to your office, Lord Marsh?
No, please, Doctor. I insist that you stay. I shall need your assistance.
Will you break anything else?
I'll try my best.
November 7th. This means that the meeting is planned for today. I have to finish my search of the office.
I'd suggest that your current weakness is perhaps more than a simple case of influenza, Lord Marsh.
Where might your companion be, Dr. Watson?
Oh, he's busy poking his nose into other people's business, I'm sure.
Dr. Watson, what are you doing?
My lord, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I must remind you about your meeting.
Is it already time? My apologies, Dr. Watson, but we are expected elsewhere. Might we offer you a lift?
You are going out? I'm not sure that's wise in your condition.
I value your opinion, but misery never rests, and I am needed.
Well, do please take good care of yourself, Lord Marsh. I'll send you my diagnosis, Dr.
Thank you, Dr. Watson. Farewell.
Holmes, come here. This is serious.
Watson, what are you doing at my table?
I just need to check one thing about Lord Marsh. My intuition tells me that Lord Marsh is hiding something about his disease. His cough, in addition to his fever and his usage of strong painkillers, leads me to believe that he is seriously ill. Let's study it more closely. Sputum with tiny drops of blood. I could take a sample and examine it under the microscope. I need to take a sample of it using the glass rod. Let us apply chemicals to color the sample. I need a pipette. This chemical should be applied third. Now, let's examine the colored sample under the microscope. Mycobacterium. It appears that Lord Marsh is seriously ill. Holmes, this is no longer a laughing matter. It is just as I feared. Lord Marsh is suffering from tuberculosis.
You don't say.
Yes, I do say. And Holmes, he will die if he is not transferred to a sanatorium as soon as possible.
And yet both Lord Marsh and Dr. Fisher are doing their best to hide this fact. How interesting.
But why?
Why indeed, Watson?
Oh, dear God, you don't think that Lord Marsh contracted tuberculosis while aiding the poor? How terrible. I have a commitment that I can't possibly cancel. Holmes, during my absence, please be extremely careful. This disease is highly contagious. And remember that we have women at home.
Thank you, Miss Alice. Until later.
I'll see you soon, Caitlin.
Where have you been?
Our neighbour lent me a book. She is so kind. I think she likes you.
I doubt that.
How is your investigation going?
It's going. Dracula?
Yes. It's forbidden reading at my boarding school. Did you know?
Well, well.
It is thrilling.
Well, well. Sweet slumber after a hard working day. On my pillow. Here it is. not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not the... That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not... That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need. That's not the one I need.
Here it is.
Cronston's Oak is in Epping Forest. That's the place indicated on George Hurst's map. Let's try to find the place from the hand-drawn map. Here it is. Drat. I'll need to hurry if I want to find out what's going on at the forest.
Father, that boy Wiggins, does he come here very often?
He helps occasionally in some of my cases. Why do you ask?
I'd like to talk to him.
Talk to him?
Father, back at school there are only girls to talk to, and they are so boring. I'm sure Wiggins has lots of exciting stories to tell about his life in London. It would be so romantic.
Caitlin, you know that Wiggins hasn't had the most fortunate life.
That only makes him more interesting.
Oh, Kate.
I'll leave you alone now.
Let's see how long you can stay alive.
Mmm!
can stay alive. You won't get far. Stay alive!
He was poor. He was poor. This man was killed recently. The body is still warm.
Find him, boys! Find him! I saw something.
Thank you. like to call this the Swamp of Despair! You won't get far!
He was killed by a shot to the forehead. My God, it's Lord Harrington's body.
Thank you.
I can hide here. I can hide here. The Quartermain Club. This must be Lord Marsh's cabin. This will help to dress my wound. Someone's coming, I better hide.
Breathe, Lord Marsh. It's almost over.
Who are you?
George Erst from the 1st Lovett Scouts, here to deliver justice.
An old soldier. How ironic. Did we refuse you on our special education program?
It's true, I was refused. An old wounded soldier is useless to you. But he can still be dangerous.
We hunted a lot in these woods, but I didn't expect to become the prey. I have lived a grand life without any limits set by others. I will die a happy man, so you won't see me begging, you festering wretch.
Prepare to meet your maker.
George, lower your rifle, please, for Tom's sake.
Holmes! My, my. An almost worthy opponent.
Tom? My Tom? If you've endangered my lad in any way, you will pay dearly.
I assure you that Tom is safe in London with a well-trusted friend. And now it's time to end this.
By all means.
George Hurst, your bloodlust ends today. You should have been apprehended weeks ago, before you killed Strobridge out of jealousy. Drop your gun. You may have wounded me, but I won't miss you.
If I ever had you in my aim, I wouldn't have merely wounded you.
Oh. The best detective in England.
Detective, take a look here.
This is how you became sick, Lord Marsh.
The beheading of your victims who were suffering from tuberculosis was what infected you. Poetic justice. I was wrong.
The best detective in England.
Enough! You'll die here, Lord Marsh, and you'll die slowly.
Mr. Hurst, you've already served brutal justice to Lord Harrington, and I hope Lord Collins and Dr. Fisher. Taking that into consideration, you may as well kill Lord Marsh and end the Quartermain Club completely. No loose ends.
Yes! Well done, Watson!
Holmes, you're playing bowls? Indoors?
Not just any old bowls, Watson. Lawn bowling.
Seriously? With your injury? No. Mrs. Hudson is going to murder you.
Well, that's it for now. Time to go. Would you care to join me?
You're incorrigible. And where are we going, Holmes?
I'm participating in the final stage of the annual tournament held by the London Archaeological Institute's Bowling Club. It's an official invitation. I'll just need to dress suitably and then we can leave.